Amén. Gloria a Dios. Una serie de mensajes que Dios ha puesto en mi corazón.
We're going to talk about a series of topics that God has put in my heart.
Se llama Dios y su providencia.
Named it God and His Providence.
Y yo quisiera orar.
And I would like to pray.
Antes de dar lectura a la palabra.
Before giving lecture to the word.
Porque Dios ha puesto esta palabra en mi corazón.
Because God has put this word in my heart.
Con una intención muy importante.
With a very important intentions.
Para nosotros como su pueblo.
For us as his people.
Y mientras usted se pone de pie.
And while you please stand.
Para orar y luego vamos a leer la Biblia.
To pray and then read the Bible.
Quiero que
I want
usted abra su corazón mientras escuche la palabra de Dios.
That you may open your heart while you listen to the word of God.
Que nunca vengamos a la casa de Dios.
That we never come to the house of the Lord.
A predicar.
To preach.
O escuchar la predicación.
Or to hear the preach. The preacher,
solo por cumplir con algo.
Just to say that you did it.
Yo para decir soy el pastor y prediqué.
Me, I can say that I'm the pastor and I preached to you.
Y usted para decir fui a la iglesia y cumplí con Dios.
And then you can say, well, I went to church and I did what I had to do.
Abramos el corazón.
Let's please open your heart truthfully.
Y a oír la voz de Dios.
And listen to the voice of God.
Padre, en el nombre de Jesús.
Father, in your name.
Yo te ruego que en este día.
I ask you that in this day.
Tú nos ayudes a asimilar tu palabra.
You help us assimilate your word.
Para poderla poner en obra.
To make it happen and practice it.
La recibimos por la fe que nos has dado.
And we receive it with the faith that you have given us.
Pero necesitamos que ella, Señor, madure en nosotros.
But we need it, Lord, that that word may mature in our lives.
Y tú nos ayudes, Señor.
And that you help us.
A comprender.
To understand.
Y a vivir.
And live.
Bajo los principios.
Under your principles.
De tu soberanía.
Of your sovereignty.
Y de tu providencia.
And your providence.
Bendice esta palabra.
Please bless this
en
word.
En nuestros corazones.
In our hearts.
Porque esta es tu palabra.
Because this is your word.
Ya está bendita.
It's already holy.
Pero en nuestros corazones.
But in our hearts.
Bendícenos con ella.
Bless us with it.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Amén.
Amen.
Busca el libro de Ruth.
If you can come with me to the book of Ruth.
Y vaya al capítulo 2.
And go to turn to chapter 2.
Y esto es continuación.
And this is a continuation.
De algo que ya Dios nos ha venido hablando como iglesia.
Something that God has already been speaking to us as a church.
Acerca de la serie que predicamos acerca del Salmo 126.
About the last sermon that we had on Psalm 127.
Estudiando de ese tema.
Talking about that topic.
Dios me dirigió aquí.
God took me here.
Pero obviamente Dios nos va a hablar mucho más.
But obviously God is going to talk today even more.
Dice la Biblia.
And the Bible says.
A partir del versículo 1.
Starting from verse 1.
Tenía Noemí un pariente de su marido, hombre rico de la familia de Elimelech, el cual se llamaba Boaz.
And Naomi had a kinsman of her husband's, mighty man of wealth, of the family Elimelech, and his name was Boaz.
Y Ruth la Moabita dijo a Noemi, te ruego que me dejes ir al campo y recoger espigas en pos de aquel a cuyos ojos hallaré gracia. Y ella le respondió, ve, hija mía.
And Ruth the Moabite said unto Naomi, let me now go to the field and glean ears of corn after him in whose sight I shall find grace. And she said unto her, go, my daughter.
Amen. Se puede sentar.
Amen. You may be seated.
Por la providencia divina.
The holy providence.
¿Qué es la providencia divina?
What is the holy providence?
La providencia y el decreto de Dios son inseparables.
The providence and God's decree is separate.
La providencia es cómo Dios ejecuta su decreto.
The providence is how God executes his decree.
Dios es rey.
God is king.
Tiene un reino.
He has a kingdom.
Y ese reino tiene principios.
And his kingdom has principles.
Y él como rey ha decretado todo.
And as a king, he has decreed everything.
¿Cómo ese decreto se cumple en cada individuo y a nivel universal?
How that decree accomplishes and meets the goal of each and every one person around the world.
Se conoce como la providencia divina.
It's known as the holy providence.
Cada detalle en tu vida y en mi vida.
Every single detail in your life and my life
ha sido decretada.
Has been decreed.
Y por providencia.
And by providence
se ha ido manifestando.
It's been manifested.
Nosotros experimentamos el cumplimiento del decreto divino.
We experience the accomplishment of the decree in our lives.
A través de la providencia.
Through the providence.
Eso se conoce como providencia.
And that's why it's known as the providence.
Es la relación de Dios con sus criaturas.
It's the relationship of God with his creatures.
En cómo él manifiesta su decreto.
On how he manifests his decree.
El propósito de esta palabra.
The purpose of this word.
Es que nuestro conocimiento como hijos de Dios.
Is that our knowledge of sons and daughters of God.
En cuanto a Dios y su providencia.
On God's providence.
Sane.
Heals.
Porque hay mucha distorsión.
Because there's a lot of distortion.
Y hay enfermedad espiritual.
And there's spiritual sickness.
En cuanto a esto.
When it comes to this.
Muchas veces el hombre piensa.
Many times men, us, we think.
Que aunque Dios da el decreto.
That even though God gives us the decree.
El decreto, el cumplimiento del decreto está sujeto a la decisión humana.
The accomplishment of the decree is subjected to human's choices.
Muchas veces pensamos.
Many times we think,
en la vida práctica,
that in the practical life, everyday life,
que sí, Dios decreta,
that yeah, God has decreed something,
pero Dios está sujeto,
but God is subjected
a la decisión,
to our decision,
de la criatura,
of the creature,
para que se manifieste,
so that way it can manifest itself.
En otras palabras,
in other words,
si yo no decido,
if I don't decide to do it,
no se manifiesta,
it's not going to manifest,
aunque él lo haya decretado,
even though he has already decreed it.
Oímos eso y decimos, no, yo sé que eso no es así.
Oh, we hear that and like, whoa, 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 that's not right.
Pero en la práctica,
but in practice,
lo hacemos así.
We do it.
Y eso requiere sanidad.
And that very specific point requires healing.
Y esto es un propósito, uno de los propósitos fundamentales.
And this is a very fundamental principle.
Y aunque le parezca usted curioso o no.
And even if you, it scratches your curiosity.
El libro de
or not,
Ruth es un libro fascinante.
The book of Ruth is very fascinating.
Y es un libro que poco se habla de él.
And not many people speak and preach about it.
Pero si hay un libro en la Biblia.
But if there's a book in the Bible.
Donde en esta historia maravillosa.
Where this great story.
Podemos ver la mano providencial de Dios obrar.
We can see the providence hand of God work.
Es en el libro de Ruth.
It's in Ruth, in the book of Ruth.
Por eso es un libro inspirado.
That's why it's an inspired book.
Porque presenta,
because it presents,
de una manera clara,
in a such a clear way,
lo que estamos hablando,
what we're talking about today,
como todo,
how everything,
aun las decisiones,
even decisions,
que nosotros tomamos,
that we take,
están conforme,
are conformed,
a un decreto,
to a decree,
y de manera providencial,
in a providence way,
se van tomando y se van ejecutando,
they are being executed.
Mire esto.
Look at this.
En el capítulo 1 de Ruth.
In the chapter 1 of Ruth.
Si usted va al capítulo 1.
If you go just one page, chapter 1.
Y en el mismo verso 1.
And on verse 1.
Mire esto.
Look at this.
Dice, aconteció en los días que gobernaban los jueces, que hubo hambre en la tierra, y un varón de Belén de Judá fue a morar en los campos de Moab, él, su mujer y sus dos hijos.
Now it came to pass in the days when the judges ruled that there was a famine in the land. And a certain man of Bethlehem, Judah, went to sojourn in the country of Moab, he and his wife and his two sons.
Y dice que el nombre de aquel varón era Elimelech y el de su mujer Noemi y los hombres de sus hijos eran Malón, Kilión, Efrateos de Belén de Judá. Y llegaron pues a los campos de Moab y se quedaron allí.
And the name of the man was Elimelech. And the name of his wife, Naomi. And the name of his two sons, Malon, Kilion, Ephrates of Bethlehem, Judah. And they came into the country of Moab and continued there.
Y murió Elimelech, marido de Noemi, y quedó ella con sus dos hijos, los cuales tomaron para sí mujeres moabitas, El nombre de una era Orfa y el nombre de la otra Ruth, y habitaron allí unos 10 años.
And Elimelech, Naomi's husband, died, and she was left and her two sons. And they took them wives of the woman of Moab. The name of one was Orpha, and the name of the other Ruth. And they dwelled there about 10 years.
Yo quiero que usted mire esto.
I want you to look at this.
En el verso 1 dice,
in verse 1 it says,
que cuando gobernaban los jueces,
that when the judges ruled,
hubo hambre en la tierra.
There was a famine.
Y se tomó una decisión.
And a decision was taken.
Este hombre Elimelech,
this man Elimelech,
se fue.
Left.
Porque había hambre.
Because they were hungry, it's a famine.
Escuche esto.
Listen to this.
Yo voy a ir con calma.
I'm going to go slowly.
Que Dios quiere que nosotros asimilemos esto.
That God wants us to really assimilate this.
Elimelech se fue con su familia.
Elimelech fled, he left with his family.
Buscando un bienestar.
Looking for a better life.
Ante una circunstancia de hambre.
Through circumstances of being hungry.
Cualquiera de nosotros que oye eso,
any of us that hear that,
cree que esa fue una buena decisión.
Think that was a good decision, logically.
Hay hambre.
There's hungry. I'm hungry.
Yo me voy.
I'm leaving.
Como padre de familia,
as a father of my family,
yo tengo que buscar bienestar.
I need to look certainty and be stable with my family.
Y aquí hay hambre.
But here where I'm at right now, there's a famine.
Fíjate cómo empieza este libro.
Look how this book starts.
Diciéndonos nosotros,
telling us,
que ante una necesidad como hambre,
that through a situation like a famine,
un hombre toma una decisión,
a man takes a decision,
con su familia,
with his family,
que es lógica.
That is logic.
Si hay hambre, vete.
If you're hungry, leave.
Si hay problema, vete.
If there's a problem, leave.
Si hay mucha lucha, vete.
If there's too much of a hassle, leave.
Dios va a ir conmigo donde vaya.
God's gonna come with me wherever I go, right?
Y aquí hay hambre.
Right here, right now.
Las circunstancias me obligan a buscar bienestar.
The circumstances are making me leave.
Así empieza este libro.
That's how this book starts.
Aconteció, dice.
Now it came to pass. That's how it starts.
Llega ese momento en la vida.
There comes the moment in our lives.
Cosas acontecen.
Things just happen.
Circunstancias que vemos.
Circumstances that we see.
Tomamos decisiones lógicas.
We take logical decisions.
Hay problema.
There's a problem.
Yo me voy.
I'm leaving.
Cuando Elimelech se fue,
when Elimelech left,
se murió.
He died.
Y el hambre que él pensó que iba a sufrir,
and the famine and the hunger that he thought was going to suffer,
en Belén,
in Belén,
no ocurrió.
Didn't happen.
Porque 10 años después,
because 10 years later,
después que la mujer que era viuda,
after his wife was left widow when he died,
y las nueras que eran viudas,
and the ones that were widow as well,
y ella pierde a su marido y sus hijos,
and she loses her husband and her sons,
regresaron a Belén,
they go back to Belén,
donde supuestamente va a haber hambre,
where supposedly there was a famine.
Muchas veces nos movemos,
many times we see,
pensando que es lo mejor,
thinking what is best for us.
Pensando que en otro sitio voy a estar mejor.
Thinking that in another place I'm going to be way better.
Porque donde estoy está mal.
Because where I'm at I'm wrong.
Pero cuando yo me voy,
but when I leave,
después me entero que las cosas no son tan malas.
Then we think that things are not that bad.
Y me cuentan pérdida.
And now I start losing.
¿Quién nos ha dicho a nosotros?
Who has told us?
Que de la manera en que Dios manifiesta su decreto,
that the way that God manifests his decree,
está sujeto a nosotros.
Is subjected to us.
Que mi decisión regula eso.
That my decision regulates his decree.
¿Quién ha enseñado eso?
Who has taught us that?
No el Dios de la Biblia.
Not the holy God that I serve.
No el Dios de esta que habló esta Biblia, esta palabra.
Not the God that spoke this word.
Cuando ella regresaron,
when they came back,
regresaron de donde habían salido.
They came back from where they left.
Habían salido una familia grande.
They left as a big family.
Y ahora solo regresaron dos.
And now only two came back.
Noemí y Ruth.
Noemi, Ruth.
Porque Orfa,
because Orfa
tomó otro camino,
took another path,
que estaba dentro de la providencia divina.
That was also to the holy providence of God.
Y se separó de Noemi.
And they she separated from Noemi.
Mira cómo Dios todo lo controla.
Look how God controls everything.
Pensando nosotros que la decisión la estoy tomando yo solito.
Thinking that we're taking our own decisions and just us.
Sin Dios violentar la libertad que nos ha dado. Sin Dios violentar, if without God breaking the freedom that He gave us. Él influye en nuestras decisiones de acuerdo a su providencia.
He still influences our decisions through the way that He wants us to happen.
Y no nos sentimos obligados.
And we don't feel obligated.
Entonces, ¿por qué?
Then why?
Llegan esas circunstancias.
This circumstance.
¿Por qué Dios nos pone en esa posición?
Why does God put us in those decisions, in those positions?
Para enseñarnos.
To teach us.
Que su providencia.
That is providence.
Para nosotros.
For us.
Es la mejor.
It's the best.
Nosotros no lo creemos.
We don't believe it.
Decimos amén.
We say amen.
Pero a la hora de la verdad.
But when it push up.
Cuando las circunstancias llegan.
When the circumstances come.
Nos falta aprender la lección.
We still lack on learning the lesson.
Lo oímos.
We hear it.
Amén.
Amen.
Pero en la práctica.
But in practice.
Es como yo lo veo.
It's how I see it.
Entonces no lo creo.
So I don't believe.
Digo que lo creo.
I say I believe.
Estoy tratando de convencerme a mí mismo que lo creo.
I'm trying to ought to convince myself that I believe.
Pero no lo creo.
But I don't.
Por eso.
That's why.
Dios.
God.
Nos está retando.
Is challenging us.
Y nos está llevando.
And He's taking us.
A un momento como cristianos.
In a moment as Christians in our lives.
De nosotros asimilar.
To assimilate.
O sea, extraer los nutrientes.
To extract the nutrients.
Para que nos dé vigor y fuerza.
So we get bigger and stronger.
A nuestro hombre interior.
To our interior self.
Su palabra.
His word.
Nosotros no podemos seguir comiendo buen pasto.
We just can't keep eating the regular grass.
Solo para llenarnos la panza.
Just so we can get full.
El buen pasto.
The good grass.
Es para que nos nutra.
It's so it can give us nutrients.
No solo para empancinarnos.
Just not to get full and feel satisfied.
Y hay ovejas empancinadas.
And there's sheep that are full and satisfied.
Comen bien.
They eat good.
Pero no están asimilando.
But they're not assimilating.
¿Cómo se sabe?
How do you know?
En la manera en que se relacionan con el Dios y su providencia.
In the way that they have a relationship of in their God and the providence.
¿Y cómo eso se sabe?
And how do you know that?
Por las decisiones que tomamos.
Through the decisions that we take.
¿Y cómo hablamos y pensamos al tomarlas?
And how we think and talk about taking them.
En el capítulo 2 leímos.
In chapter 2 we read
que Noemi tenía un pariente de su marido.
That Noemi had a partner from his her husband.
Y dice que ese hombre era rico.
That that man was rich.
De la familia de Elimelech.
Of the family of Elimelech.
El cual se llamaba Boaz.
And what his name was Boaz.
Elimelech. Se va de Belén.
Leaves Belén.
Porque hay hambre.
Because there's a famine.
Y tiene un pariente rico.
And he has a relative that's rich.
Dice el texto.
I'm not making this up. This is what the scripture is saying.
Que Noemí tenía un pariente de su marido.
That Elimelech had a relative.
O sea, de Elimelech.
Of Elimelech.
Y dice que era rico.
And it says here that he was rich.
De hecho.
Meaning.
La palabra ahí, rico.
The word here, rich.
La palabra pariente, la palabra pariente, debo decir.
The word, I mean the word relative here.
Es la palabra hebrea Goel.
It's the word
Goel. La palabra hebrea Goel. The Hebrew word that you pronounce Goel. Significa.
Means.
Una persona ayudadora ilustre.
A person that is there to help.
Elimelech tenía un pariente.
Elimelech had a family member.
Rico.
That was rich.
Jefe.
He was a chief.
Influente.
He was an influence.
Ayudador.
Help people.
Sostenedor.
He sustained people.
Y Elimelech se fue.
So Elimelech left.
Hay veces que nos movemos.
There's sometimes that we move from place to place.
No apreciando la ayuda que tenemos al frente.
And we don't see and appreciate the help that we have in front of us.
Santo. Aleluya. Elimelech estaba en Belén.
Elimelech was in Belén.
Boaz estaba en Belén.
Boaz was in Belén.
Boaz era rico.
And Boaz was rich.
Elimelech tenía la ayuda.
He had the help.
Pero se fue.
And he still left.
Y murió.
And died.
Y sus hijos.
And his sons.
Cualquiera diría.
Anybody would say.
Wow.
Wow.
Qué dura le ha dado la vida a Noemí, man.
This life for Noemí was tough.
Noemí.
Noemí.
No es digna, no nos está llamando a que le tengamos pena.
She's not here so we can feel sorry for her.
Por eso su historia está plasmada en la Biblia.
That's why this story is planted in the Bible.
No es pena.
It's not to feel sorry.
Lo que se le puede tener a Noemí.
That we may feel for Noemí.
Es respeto.
It's respect.
A cómo ella se sometió al proceso de Dios.
On how she submitted herself to the process.
Para entender la providencia divina.
To understand the holy providence of God.
No es pena.
It's not to feel sorry.
Es que si ella no tiene esas pérdidas,
but if she doesn't have those losses,
no veríamos la mano de Dios.
We won't see the God's hand.
¿Sabe algo?
You know what?
Mientras nosotros vivamos,
meanwhile we live,
queriendo saber de antemano,
wanting to know the future,
lo que la mano de Dios va a hacer,
on what God's hand will do,
vamos a tener problemas.
We're going to have problems.
La manera de nosotros poder mejor entender,
the best way for us to understand,
la mano de Dios lo que ha hecho,
the God's hand on what he's going to do, what he has done,
es cuando miramos atrás.
It's when we look back.
Hay gente que vive,
there's people that live,
queriendo saber qué Dios va a hacer,
wanting to know what God's going to do next,
para evitar fracaso,
so that way they can avoid failure.
Se les olvida,
and they forget,
mirar cómo desde el pasado,
look on how in their past,
la mano invisible de Dios los ha traído hasta su presente.
The powerful and invisible hand of God has brought them here.
Es la mejor manera de entender la providencia.
And that's the best way to understand.
No es sabiendo el futuro.
It's not knowing the future.
Es entendiendo cómo llegaste donde estoy.
It's understanding how you got here.
Pero ahora hay un afán de saber lo que Dios va a hacer, lo que Dios va a hacer, lo que Dios va a hacer.
But now we're so anxious, what's God's going to do next? What is it? I want to know.
Que hombres y mujeres ahora decretan sobre Dios.
The men and women nowadays are decreeing what God's going to do.
El decreto del hombre ante Dios es nulo.
Man's decree against God is
powerless.
Thank you.
Es atrevido.
It's daring to God.
Es irrespetuoso.
It's disrespectful.
Es irreverente.
It's irreverent.
Es una ofensa a Dios.
It offends God.
Y eso se hace bajo emoción.
And that you see that through emotions.
Y no entendiendo la providencia divina.
And not truly understanding God's providence.
De acuerdo a la escritura.
According to the scripture.
No a mí.
Not me or him.
A Dios.
To God.
Yo estoy en el mismo proceso que usted.
Because we in the same process as everybody else. Yeah.
Cuando Dios me ministre y me habla acerca de esto.
When God ministers and speaks to me about this.
Me dice, ¿cuál es el afán de saber lo que voy a hacer?
He tells me, what is your anxiety of wanting to know what God's going to do next?
Debes dar gracias por lo que hasta donde has llegado.
You just got to give grace on how far he has taken you.
La evidencia.
The evidence.
Divina a nosotros.
The divine evidence.
Experimental.
To experiment.
La que experimentamos nosotros.
The one that we experiment.
La que él da en su misericordia.
The one that he gives us through his mercy.
Y por su gracia.
And by his grace.
Es en donde tú y yo estamos y cómo llegamos hasta donde
estamos.
Is
where we are right now and how we got here.
Hazte esta pregunta.
Ask yourself this question.
¿Cómo?
How?
¿Tú has llegado hasta donde has llegado?
Have you gotten to where you've gotten today?
Hazte esta pregunta.
Ask this other question.
¿Qué tú haces aquí?
What are you doing here?
La respuesta.
The answer.
Providencia divina.
Holy Providence.
Pero ahora aquí.
But now today.
Quiero saber qué pasa mañana.
I want to know what's going to happen tomorrow.
Mira esto.
And look at this.
Verso 2, capítulo 2.
Chapter 2.
Yo no voy a terminar todo esto hoy.
I'm not going to finish all
this.
Le dije
que es una miniserie.
This is going to be a mini series.
El otro capítulo es la próxima semana.
The next chapter is going to be next Sunday.
Aunque se celebre el Día de los Padres, vamos a hablar aquí de esto.
Even if it's going to be Father's Day, we're still going to speak about this.
Porque si alguien necesita entender esto, somos los padres.
Because if somebody needs to understand this, it's the fathers.
Porque Amalek era padre.
Because Amalek was a father.
Y muchas de las decisiones que afectan a la familia.
And many decisions that affect families.
La toman los padres y los hombres.
Fathers or men take it.
Así que si usted quiere un buen mensaje la próxima semana, si Dios permite.
So if you want another good message next week, God permitting.
No se pierda el otro capítulo.
Don't miss the next chapter.
Ahora,
now,
verso 2 dice.
Verse 2 says.
Y Ruth la Moabita dijo a Noemí.
And Ruth the Moabite said unto Noemi.
Me llama la atención cómo la Biblia llama a Ruth.
And it comes to my attention how the Bible names Ruth.
La Moabita.
The Moabite.
Extranjera.
Meaning stranger.
Ruth la extranjera.
Ruth the stranger.
Ruth la extranjera.
Ruth the stranger.
La que no era de allí.
The one that's not from there.
La viuda que llegó por allí, nadie sabía quién era.
The widow that just got there and nobody knew her or where she came from.
Ella le dice a Noemí.
She tells Noemí.
Te ruego que me dejes ir al campo.
Let me now go to the field.
Y recoger espigas en pos de aquel a cuyos ojos hallaré gracia.
And glean ears of corn after him in whose sight I shall find grace.
Y ella le respondió, ve.
And she said unto her.
Hija mía.
Go, my daughter.
Una mujer viuda.
A widow,
dos mujeres viudas,
or two widows,
en aquel entonces,
in those times,
eran unas mujeres con poca esperanza.
They were women with very, very little hope.
Escucha esto.
Listen to this.
Mire la actitud de Ruth.
And look at Ruth's attitude.
Ella es extranjera.
She's a foreigner.
Ella es viuda.
She's a widow.
Ella pierde a su marido.
She loses her husband.
Por la decisión que toma su suegro.
Through the decision. That her
father-in-law
took.
Y no se enoja con su suegra.
And doesn't get mad with their mother-in-law.
Está unida a Noemí.
They're united.
Escucha esto.
Listen to this.
Mira qué revolú de familia hay aquí.
Look at this family drama we're about to get into.
Ella le dice.
And she tells her.
De hecho, le pide permiso.
Actually, she's asking her for permission.
Fíjate el corazón de Ruth.
Look at Ruth's heart.
Sumiso.
Just submissive.
Sumisa.
It's submissive.
Te ruego que me dejes ir.
She's begging, pleading for her to let her go to the fields.
A recoger espigas.
To gather corn.
Hay hambre.
They're hungry.
Si no buscaban de comer, se morían.
They don't find something to eat, they're gonna die.
Pero esto es lo que a mí me llama la atención.
But this is what catches my attention.
recoger espigas. Ella dijo, recoger espigas.
And glean ears of corn.
En pos de aquel, detrás de aquel, aquel a cuyos ojos hallare gracia. Verso 2.
Yeah. And ears of corn after him whose sight I shall find grace.
Ruth estaba bien consciente.
And Ruth was very conscious.
Que lo que ella se proponía hacer.
So what was she proposed herself to do?
Iba a ser determinado por la gracia de Dios.
Was going to be determined by the grace of God.
Realmente nosotros pensamos así.
Reality, do we really think like that? In reality.
Realmente nosotros relacionamos con Dios desde esa actitud.
Do we really have a relationship the way Ruth had with God?
Que lo que nos proponemos hacer.
That we propose, what we propose ourselves to do.
En medio de desesperación.
In the midst of desperation.
Esta mujer aquí no está hablando de nada vanidoso.
This lady here is not talking about anything.
Esta mujer está hablando de sobrevivencia extrema.
This lady is talking about survival.
Si no recoge espiguitas del suelo.
If she doesn't gather corn.
Se muere.
They die.
Vida o muerte es esto.
It's life or death, that's it.
Morirte de hambre, literalmente.
You literally will die because you're hungry.
En medio de una condición tal.
In the midst of this kind of situation.
Ella sabía que su determinación.
She knew that her determination.
Iba a estar sujeta.
Was going to be subjected.
A gracia.
To grace.
Y como es sumisa.
And how she's so submissive.
Pide permiso.
She asked for permission.
Reconocía que Noemí.
She recognizes that Noemí.
Tenía sobre ella.
Had over her.
¿Qué? Autoridad.
Authority.
Era respeto.
It was respect.
Esto es respeto.
This is what is called respect.
¿Con cuánto respeto?
Well, how much respect?
Nosotros tratamos los asuntos de Dios.
Do we really treat the situations with God?
¿Cuánto respeto tenemos?
How much respect do we have towards him?
Yo me pregunto.
That's what I ask myself.
No, que es que a mí se me faltan el respeto, yo te lo falto para
atrás. No, if somebody disrespect me, I'm going to disrespect
them. Yo seré cristiano y todo, Manuel, pero tú me la haces, tú me la pagas.
I'm going to be a Christian, Dad, but if you're going to do something to me, I'm going to do it.
Todavía yo no he madurado a ponerle otra mejilla.
I'm still not mature to put the other cheek.
Eso fue Jesucristo.
That was Jesus Christ, not me.
Yo te meto un y me arrepiento.
I'm going to then repent later.
Conmigo sí que no.
That's not how we do things.
Porque Dios está tratando conmigo.
Because that God is going to deal with me in his own way.
Qué mucha excusa.
There's so many excuses that we have.
Todo el mundo póngase el bozal para no verlo.
Everybody,
lucha, mi alma alaba la gloria.
I don't see your facial expressions.
Estoy casi asimilando.
We have to assimilate this.
Mastica y traga.
Chew it, swallow it.
Mastica.
Chew it.
Traga.
Swallow.
Voy con calma.
I'm going slowly.
Para que no me digan.
So that you don't say.
Pastores, que estamos meditando.
Pastor, we're just meditating. All right.
Esto está hablando de decisiones.
And here we're talking about decisions.
El libro de Ruth es providencia divina.
Ruth's book is holy providence.
En medio de decisiones humanas.
Through human decisions. That's the book.
Eso es inspirado por Dios.
And that is inspired by God.
Significa que es palabra de Dios.
Meaning it's God's word.
Que tenemos que prestar atención.
That we have to pay attention. Just because the book is small doesn't mean it's not relevant.
Es triste que este libro.
It's sad that this book.
Se ha usado desde una perspectiva.
It's been used in a perspective.
Más emocional que espiritual.
More emotional than spiritual.
La mayoría de los mensajes que yo he oído de Ruth.
The majority of the messages that I've heard about the book of Ruth.
Son de aspectos emocionales que ella vivió y Noemí y Orfa y todo esto.
Are aspects of emotional decisions that Noemí or Orfa had taken.
Que son reales.
That are, yes, they're true.
Pero la enseñanza de este libro.
But the teachings of this book.
Es que en medio de decisiones emocionales.
Is that through emotional decisions.
Está la providencia divina obrando.
The providence of God is still there and is doing his work.
Cumpliendo el decreto divino.
Accomplishing the divine decree.
Es el contexto bíblico y espiritual de este libro.
That's the biblical context of this book.
No es la vida emocional de ninguna de estos personajes.
It's not the emotional lives of any of these.
Que aunque está ahí para que aprendamos.
People that they're there so we can learn.
No es aprender de las emociones de otro.
Not to learn from another person's emotions.
Es que cuando las emociones de otros están en la Biblia.
Is that when other people's emotions are in the Bible?
Lo que tenemos que aprender es cómo Dios trató en medio de eso.
Is how they took care of that situation through those times.
Noemí le dice,
Noemí says,
al final del verso 2,
at the end of verse 2,
ve, hija mía,
go, my daughter.
Noemí trataba a Ruth como hija.
Noemí treated Ruth as her own daughter.
Ruth trataba a Noemí como madre.
And Ruth treated Noemí as her mom.
Aunque la decisión del marido de Noemí,
even though Noemí's husband's decisions,
le costó la vida al marido de Ruth,
caused the husband of Ruth to die. Literally die.
¿Sabe quién iba a salir al campo a pasar la vergüenza de ir a recoger espiga?
And you know who's going to be the take the walk of shame to go and gather corn?
Ruth.
Ruth was.
Por eso dice que era la Moabita.
And that's why here it says she was the Moabite, the foreigner, the stranger.
¿Quién es esta extranjera?
Who is the stranger, foreigner, widow?
Que está recogiendo migaja detrás de nosotros.
That is scavenging corn behind us.
Ese estigma social.
That social stigma.
Ese estigma laboral.
That laboral stigma.
Le iba a sufrir Ruth.
Ruth was going to be the one that was suffering it.
Eso es humildad.
And that's humility.
En cambio Elimelech.
Therefore Elimelech.
Teniendo a Boaz.
Having Boaz.
Y miedo a lo que él veía.
But scared of what he was seeing.
Se fue.
He left.
Y murió.
And died.
Y ahora en la tierra de un pariente de Elimelech.
And now on a land of a relative of Elimelech.
Viene esta extranjera.
Here comes a stranger.
A sobrevivir.
To survive.
You got the picture? ¿Lo ve?
Do you see it?
¿O no lo ve?
Or you don't see it still?
O lo veo y no lo quiere ver.
Or do you see it but you don't want to believe it?
O lo ve y dice no, pero como quiera no.
Or you see it but you're still in denial. No, that's not how it is.
Verso 3.
Verse 3.
Fue pues.
And she went.
Y llegando espigó en el campo en pos, o sea, detrás.
And came and gleaned in the field after the reapers, meaning that she was behind them.
De los segadores, y aconteció que aquella parte del campo era de Boaz, el cual era de la familia de Elimelech.
And her hap was too light on a part of the field belonging unto Boaz, who was the kindred of Elimelech.
Te voy a traer esto al contexto del 2020.
I'm going to put this in 2020 words.
Levítico 19.
In Leviticus 19.
Verso 9 y 10.
Verse 9 and 10.
Dios estableció.
God established.
Que cuando se cogía la cosecha.
That when you were gathering your when you
no se recogiera todo.
You don't gather everything.
Se dejara algo.
You left something behind.
Para la viuda.
For the widows.
Y los extranjeros.
And the strangers. In the
Levítico 19, verso 9 y 10, léalo.
In Leviticus 19, is there, read it.
Dios le había dicho a su pueblo,
God had told his people,
que cuando recogiera las cosechas,
that when they sowed everything,
dejaran caer algo,
left something behind,
y dejaran algo,
and they left something,
para los que cogían food stamps.
For those that get food stamps.
Ese era el sistema de ayuda social de Dios.
That was God's social help in those times.
Que los que recogen en abundancia,
that those that gather in abundance,
dejen algo de la tierra, del fruto,
leave something behind,
para el extranjero,
for the foreigners,
y la viuda,
and the widows,
tengan que comer,
they have to eat too,
y los niños de ella,
and their kids.
Ese era el sistema de ayuda social.
And that was the system.
Ese era el sistema de los food stamps de Dios.
And that was the God, that's where God's food stamps.
Ese era el weak de Dios.
That's how it is.
The weak.
Oh, the weak of God.
El TANF. El welfare.
Welfare.
A su nombre.
Hallelujah.
Esto es más viejo que el frío. Usted no lo había visto.
You've never seen this.
Entonces, mira lo que Ruth le dice a Noemí.
So look what Ruth
tells acá en el 2020,
Noemí.
Marina.
Right, in words.
Le dice, suegra.
Tells you, hey,
déjame ir a coger cupones.
Let me go get some food stamps.
Y la suegra le dijo, ve.
And she said, well, go ahead and go.
Y ponme de dependiente.
And claim me as a dependent as well.
Hermano, si esto ya está inventado.
This already happened. I'm not inventing
la providencia
this.
Divina.
The providence of God.
Corre esto. Lo quiera ver o no.
Runs the world, believe it or not.
Corre tu vida y mi vida. Lo quiera ver o no.
It runs through your life and my life. You want to believe it or not.
2020, te lo contextualicé en el 2020.
I contextualized it for you in the year
2020.
So Ruth had the right for food stamps.
Cualificada.
She was qualified.
Viuda y extranjera y con hambre.
She was widow, she was hungry, and she was a foreigner.
Y una anciana de dependiente.
And she claimed a dependent, an old lady for a dependent.
Cualquier social worker le decía, aprobado el caso.
Any social worker today would have been, you're granted.
Y aunque era un derecho.
And even though it's a right.
Mira esto.
Look at this.
Ay, papá, Dios. ¿Usted había leído a Ruth así?
Have you heard? Have you truly read the
escuche
book of
esto.
Ruth like this?
Mire esto.
Look at this.
Mire esto. Entonces ella fue a recoger en pos de los segadores. Se fue a coger food stamps.
So she left to get food stamps.
Pero de donde suplía la comida.
But where the supply of food was.
El mayor inversionista era Boaz.
The biggest investor was Boaz.
Boaz era.
Boaz was.
Un gran terrateniente.
A great.
Dice que era rico.
He said that he was rich.
Y era familia de Milet.
And he was a family member of.
O sea, que ella tenía.
So therefore, she had.
Ella tenía alguien de influencia.
So she had somebody in
dentro de la oficina de food stamps.
In the office of food stamps.
Ella conocía al jefe del jefe del jefe de la social.
So she really knew the boss's boss.
De hecho, ni lo conocía.
So she knew him personally.
Lo que pasa es que mira dónde lo ubica la gracia.
But well, look where grace comes.
Mira dónde lo ubica la providencia.
Look where providence doing his work.
Yo te pregunto.
I ask you.
La providencia divina no ha sido la que te ha ubicado aquí.
Is the holy providence not the one that has placed you in this place today?
Tú y yo creemos que llegamos aquí porque yo me monté en un avión y llegué.
We think that we got here because you either got on a plane or got in your car and arrived.
Tú y yo creemos que llegamos aquí manejando el carro.
You think that we got here because we woke up, rolled out of bed, got in the car and came here.
Tú y yo estamos convencidos de que el día que salga porque yo me fui porque me quise ir.
We are truly convinced that the time we go to church is because I decided to go.
Verso 4.
Verse 4.
Y aquí que Boaz vino de Belén.
And behold, Boaz came from Bethlehem.
He aquí, dice.
And behold, that's what it says.
Llega un momento.
It comes a time.
Donde tú empiezas a tener revelación.
We start getting revelations.
En tu experiencia personal.
In your personal experiences.
Con la mano invisible de Dios.
With the invisible hand of God.
Dice.
Says,
y aquí que Boaz vino de Belén.
And behold, Boaz came from Bethlehem.
Y dijo a los segadores.
And said unto the reapers.
Mira el carácter del jefe.
Look at the character of the big boss.
Jehová sea con vosotros.
The Lord be with you.
Esa expresión.
That small expression.
Que llega el patrón.
That the boss comes.
El mero mero.
The mero mero, the big guy, the chief.
Y le dice a sus empleados,
and tell his employees,
Jehová sea con vosotros.
The Lord be with you.
Habla del carácter de vos.
Really speaks about the character of Boaz.
Un hombre creyente de Dios.
A believer of God.
Un hombre humilde.
A humble man.
No hablaba desde un pedestal a su siervo.
Didn't speak on a status level towards.
Llegaba al sitio echando bendición.
He will get to his work. Blessing.
No llegaba demandando, mira cuánto recogieron.
He didn't come demanding, hey, how much did you.
¿Qué hace aquel allá sentado?
What is he doing over there sitting down?
Ven acá tú que estás haciendo sin hacer nada. No llego así.
Hey, Nuga, come here, I need to speak to you.
Jehová sea con vosotros, le dice a su gente.
He said to or be with you to his employees.
Amabilidad.
Humbleness.
¿Ve?
You see?
Le dice. Y ellos respondieron.
And they answered him.
Jehová te bendiga.
The Lord bless thee.
Wow. ¿Qué relación?
That's a relationship.
Entre el patrón y los empleados.
With the big boss, the chief, and his employees.
Significa que hasta en las relaciones laborales.
Even in labor of relationships.
Es Jehová el centro.
God is still the center.
El jefe dice, Jehová sea con vosotros, y los empleados le dicen, Jehová te bendiga.
The boss says, may the Lord bless you, and his employees say, God bless you back.
Y vos, verso 5, le dijo a su criado, el mayordomo de los segadores.
Verse 5, then Boaz unto his servant that was set over the reapers.
¿De quién es esa joven?
Whose damsel is this?
Mira la pregunta. ¿De quién es esta joven?
Whose damsel is this?
Meaning, no la había visto.
He's never seen this lady.
La tierra es de él.
It's his own land.
Él conoce a sus empleados.
He knows his employees.
Y esta mujer viene atrás.
And this foreigner lady
recogiendo
comes,
espiguita.
Gathering, scavenging whatever's left.
El criado del mayordomo de los segadores le respondió y dijo.
And the servant that was set over the reapers answered and said.
Es la joven moabita que volvió con Noemí de los campos de Moab.
It is the Moabitish damsel that came back with Naomi out of the country of Moab.
Y ha dicho.
And she said,
te ruego que me dejes recoger y juntar tras los segadores entre las gavillas.
I pray you, let me glean and gather after the reapers among the sheaves.
Entró pues y desde por la mañana hasta ahora sin descansar ni aún por un momento.
So she came and hath continued even from the morning until now, that she tarried a little in the house.
Vos pregunta.
And then said Boaz unto Ruth.
¿Quién es ella?
Hearest thou not?
El mayordomo dice.
The big guy says.
Es joven moabita.
It's a young damsel.
Vino con Noemí.
Came with Naomi.
Y dijo.
And said.
Te ruego. Ella tenía derecho a food stamps.
She had the right for food stamps.
De acuerdo a Levítico 19.
According to Leviticus 19.
Ella no llegó a decirle al mayordomo.
She didn't come and tell the boss.
Mira, yo soy viuda.
Look, I'm a widow.
Yo tengo una anciana en casa.
I have this old lady back in the
Nosotros
house.
Tenemos hambre.
And we hungry.
Levítico 19 dice.
Leviticus 19 says.
Que ustedes me tienen que dejar coger lo que sobra.
You need to let me gather whatever's left.
Y yo tengo ese derecho.
And I have that right.
Ella no llegó así.
She didn't come with that attitude.
Ella se acercó a ese hombre.
She got close to that man.
Que era un empleado.
That was an employee.
Y le dijo, te ruego.
An employer, and said, I beg.
Me dejes recoger.
Let me gather some food.
Nosotros a veces creemos.
Sometimes we think.
Que porque la Biblia nos dice unas cosas.
Because the Bible tells us some
a las cuales tenemos derecho.
That we have the right to.
Nuestra actitud no importa.
Our attitude doesn't matter.
Eso es bíblico, eso es mi derecho.
That's biblical, it's in the Bible, that's my right.
Y esa arrogancia.
And we have an arrogance.
Se nos olvida la actitud.
We forget our attitude.
Aun cuando tenemos un derecho.
Even though we still have a
Porque
right.
Porque ese derecho nos es dado por gracia.
Because that right is given to us by grace.
Y nuestra actitud.
And our attitude.
Es parte de nuestra gratitud.
Is part of our gratitude.
Otra cosa que veo aquí.
Something else that I see here.
Mire esto.
Look at this.
Siempre hay gente que te observa.
There's always people that are looking at you.
Siempre hay gente que nos están observando.
People that are observing every move we do.
Que no dicen nada.
They don't say much.
Siguen en sus quehaceres.
They still do what they do.
Los segadores siguieron segando.
The reapers kept reaping.
Pero están viendo.
But they're watching.
La gente sigue haciendo sus cosas.
People are still going to do what they got to do in their lives.
Pero nos siguen mirando.
But they're still looking at us.
¿Y qué ve la gente?
And who is this people?
¿Qué ve la gente?
What do people see?
¿Cómo nos conducimos?
How we conduct ourselves.
En nuestras decisiones de vida.
In our life decisions and the way we do things in life.
Vivimos un tiempo.
We live in a time.
Donde vivimos la era del selfie.
Where we live in the era of the selfie.
Y lo que decimos es.
And what we say is.
A la gente no le importa.
People don't care.
Me importa cero lo que la gente piense.
I care nothing of what people think about me.
¡Qué extraño!
That's strange, right?
Que Cristo,
that Christ,
que no ha habido uno más santo que él.
That has been nobody else more holy
que
than
es el
him.
Santo de los santos.
He is the holy of holy.
En cierto momento preguntó.
In a certain moment he asked.
¿Quién dice la gente que soy yo?
Who do people say that I am?
Cristo.
Christ.
¿Quién podía juzgarlo a él?
Who can judge Christ?
¿Quién lo podía acusar de pecado?
Who can accuse him of a sin?
Y él dijo.
And he's asked.
¿Quién dice la gente que soy yo?
What are the people saying who I am?
Ah, el Señor le importaba la opinión pública.
Oh, so we may say, oh, the Lord, he cared what the public said about him.
Al Señor le interesaba cuánto lo veían y lo seguían en Facebook.
Well, was the Lord interested in how many followers
en
he had
redes
on Facebook,
sociales.
In social media?
¿Quién lo conocía a él por quien verdaderamente
es? He asked, who truly knows him by who he really is?
Esa pregunta no la hizo.
He didn't ask that question.
Porque quería saber cuántos views tenía y followers en Twitter.
To see how many followers and retweets he had on Twitter.
Él no lo dijo por popularidad.
He didn't ask because of popularity.
Él lo preguntó por el conocimiento de su misión.
He asked because of the knowledge of the mission.
De su persona.
Of his person.
Porque eso iba a determinar.
Because that was going to determine.
Que el que lo conociera él por quien él es.
Because whoever knew him for what he really was.
Había tenido esa revelación del Padre.
Had that revelation through the Father.
Los discípulos le dijeron.
The disciples told
unos dicen que tú eres Jeremías.
Some say that you're Jeremiah.
Otros dicen que tú eres Juan el Bautista.
Say that you're John.
Otros dicen que tú eres Elías.
Some say that you're Elijah.
Otros dicen que tú eres uno de los profetas.
Some say that you're one of the prophets.
Y el Señor le dice a ellos, ¿y ustedes? ¿Quiénes dicen que soy yo?
And but then he asks you, who do you say I am?
Silencio.
Silence.
Y andaban con él.
And they walk with him.
Y Pedro dice. Pedro.
And Peter says,
tú eres el Cristo.
You're the Christ.
El hijo del Dios viviente.
The Son of the living God.
Y el Señor le dijo, bienaventurado eres Pedro.
And the Lord
en
said,
ese momento le dijo Cephas. Cephas.
Oh, Cephas. His name was Cephas at that time.
Porque no te lo reveló carne ni sangre.
Because nothing, no flesh or blood revealed that to
you. Que está en los cielos.
The only one that revealed that to him was the Father in heavens.
Y sobre ti.
And over you.
Sobre esa confesión.
Over that confession.
De lo que el Padre revela que yo soy el Cristo.
The Father that reveals to those people that I am Christ.
Voy a fundar mi iglesia.
I'm going to found my church.
Edificaré mi iglesia. Dijo.
I will edify my church.
Significa que si tú y yo somos iglesia.
Meaning that you and I are his church.
Es porque el Padre nos reveló que él es el Cristo.
It's because the Father revealed to us that he is Christ.
Y si él nos reveló que él es el Cristo.
And if he revealed us that he is Christ.
Tu vida y mi vida se rige por la providencia divina.
Your life and my life is connected to the holy providence.
Me voy ya.
I'm leaving.
Ya nos vamos ya.
We about to be out.
Pero quiero dejarle esto.
But I want to leave you with something else.
Hasta si el Señor lo permite la semana que viene.
Until God permitting next week.
El que te observa.
The one that is observing you.
Ve tu actitud.
Sees your attitude.
Y ve la disposición.
And sees a disposition.
Y cómo estás asimilando la providencia divina en tu vida.
And how you are assimilating the holy providence in your life.
La gente lo ve.
People see that.
Mira lo que le dijo.
Look what it says.
Ella llegó rogando que la dejáramos recoger.
She was begging for her to scavenge the food that was left.
Y dice, entró y está desde por la mañana hasta ahora sin descansar por un momento.
And she was reaping from the morning until now with no rest.
Consistencia en el trabajo.
Consistency in her work.
Esfuerzo.
Effort.
Eso se ve.
You see that.
¿Cuánto esfuerzo ponemos?
How much effort do we put?
¿Cuánta consistencia?
How much consistency?
¿Cuán laboriosos somos?
How much labor do we do?
Aun si nosotros creemos que nadie nos ve.
Even thinking or believing that nobody's watching.
Siempre te ven.
Somebody's always watching.
Pero pasa que ellos siguen en su faena. Ellos siguen en sus cosas.
But the thing is, they just keep on their daily lives.
Porque nadie venga a decirte que te está viendo.
Because somebody comes and tells you that they're watching you.
No significa que no te estén viendo.
Doesn't mean that they're not watching you.
Y que no te estén evaluando.
Or they're evaluating you.
Sin descansar por un momento.
She did not rest for one moment.
Yo lo voy a dejar hasta aquí hoy.
I'm going to leave it to here today.
Los jóvenes le llaman a esto awkward silence. Le llaman silencio extraño, raro, ¿verdad? Un silencio raro. Awkward silence. Fíjate cómo este tema.
Look how this topic
toca bien adentro.
Touches us deep.
Pero esa es la palabra de Dios.
But that's God's word.
No hay algo más difícil para nosotros.
There's nothing harder for us.
Que rendir nuestras decisiones.
That to give up our decisions.
Y someternos a la providencia divina.
And submit to the holy providence of God.
Usted dirá.
You may say.
Pastor, pero entonces fue providencia divina que Elimelech muriera y se fuera.
Well, do you think it's God's providence, holy providence, that Elimelech left and died?
Claro.
Yes.
La providencia no siempre va a dar experiencias de positiva.
Holy providence is not always going to be something positive.
La providencia divina.
The holy providence
incluye pérdidas y sufrimiento.
Includes suffering and losses.
Porque oímos la palabra providencia.
Because we hear the word providence.
Creemos que es que tiene que irme bien.
We automatically think that it's something good.
La providencia incluye aflicción.
And the providence includes affliction.
Y pérdida.
And losses.
Y momentos que hemos fracasado. O que hemos llamado fracaso.
Or moments that we may have called failure.
Entonces,
so,
aún los fracasos,
even in failure,
de los cuales todavía sufrimos,
even the ones that we're suffering today,
consecuencias,
consequences,
memorias,
memories,
recuerdo,
even more
heridas,
wounds,
cicatrices,
scars,
han sido parte de la providencia,
are part of God's providence,
caídas,
when we fall,
levantadas.
When we come up,
parte de la providencia.
It's part of the providence.
¿Qué hemos aprendido?
What have we learned?
¿Cómo lo sabemos?
How do we know?
Viendo al Dios que nos ha traído hasta donde estamos.
Looking at the God that has brought us to this place today.
Y vivamos sin miedo.
And that we may live without fear.
A lo que viene.
Of what to come.
Porque lo que viene.
Because what's coming.
Ni mi decisión ni la suya.
Nor my decision or your decision.
Lo va a detener.
It's going to stop it.
Lo va a cambiar.
Or it's going to change it.
O lo va a influenciar.
Or it's going to influence it.
Es parte de la providencia.
It's part of the providence, period.
Ahorita cantábamos.
Early we were singing.
Dios de lo imposible.
God of the impossible.
Te adoramos.
We bless you.
Eres invencible.
You are invincible.
Soberano.
You're all sovereign.
Tuya es.
Yours is.
Toda la gloria.
All glory.
Tuyo es.
All yours,
honor.
all honor.
¿Cantamos con entendimiento?
Do we really sing with knowledge?
¿Entendemos lo que estamos cantando?
Do we really understand what we're singing?
¿O es que nos gusta la melodía?
Or it's because we like the melody and the music.
Y la buena música. Y las voces.
And the voices.
Eres invencible.
You are invincible.
Soberano.
Sovereign God.
Ahorita cantábamos eso.
We were singing that, right? I'm not making this up.
No es lo mismo cantarlo que vivir.
It's not the same as singing it than to live it.
Asimile esto, hermano.
Assimilate this.
Confía en Dios.
Have faith in God.
Sometámonos a Dios.
Let's submit ourselves to him.
Si hay alguien aquí que en este día,
if there's somebody here today,
ha oído la voz de Dios,
that have heard God's voice,
a salvación de su alma,
to for salvation of their lives,
y este día,
today,
por convicción del Espíritu,
for conviction of the spirit,
le ha dejado entender claramente,
has let them clearly understand,
que necesita salvación,
that they need salvation,
que es un pecador sin arrepentimiento,
that there is, he or she is a sinner with no repentance,
y necesita el Salvador,
and needs the Savior, the one and only.
Levanta tu mano para orar contigo.
Simply just raise your hand so I can pray with you.
Una oración no te entra al reino ni te saca del reino.
One prayer does not make you go in or come out of the kingdom.
Yo no tengo la llave que te abre la puerta del cielo o te la cierra.
I don't have the key that opens the gate or closes the gate of heaven.
Cristo murió en la cruz y se rasgó un velo para que tú puedas entrar.
God died in the cross so me and you can come in.
Pero tú entras y el Padre te llama.
But you come in only if the Father calls you.
Porque nadie viene si él no le llama.
Because then nobody comes to him
si
if
Dios
it's not
te está llamando hoy.
If God is calling you,
lo que queremos simplemente es que te identifiques para orar contigo.
I just want you to identify yourself so we can pray for you.
¿Quién hoy reconoce que necesita salvación del alma?
Who today recognizes that they need salvation?
Si esa persona está aquí, levante la mano.
If that person is here today,
y de donde
está,
vamos a orar.
And wherever you're from, we can pray. You don't have
nadie
to come
te tiene que poner una mano para que tú te sientas cristiano.
Nobody has to lay hands on you so you feel Christian.
Tú eres cristiano si naces de nuevo.
You are a Christian if you're born again.
Y naces de nuevo solo si Dios te da nuevo nacimiento.
And you are born again only if God comes to you and calls you.
¿Dónde está esa persona?
So where's that person?
Si está aquí hoy.
If they're here today.
Si todos estamos.
If we're all here.
Ya en Cristo.
Already in Christ.
Pues entonces asimilemos esta palabra.
Let's assimilate this word.
Y vivamos.
And let's live.
Como el Señor quiere.
How the Lord wants.
No es hora de usted mirar a otro.
It's not time to look around at somebody else.
Para justificar lo mío.
To justify myself.
Lo suyo.
Or you.
Es hora de usted mirarse usted.
It's time to look at yourself.
No, pero mira aquel.
No, but look at
no,
that
pero
person.
Mira aquella.
But look at her.
No, pero mira lo que me hacen.
But look what she does to me.
Elimelech dijo lo mismo.
Elimelech said the same thing.
Esto está malo, me voy.
Is this bad? I'm leaving.
Y murió.
And died.
Él y sus hijos.
Him and his two sons.
Inclinemos el rostro.
Let's bow our heads.
Padre.
Father.
Tu palabra ha sido dicha.
Your word has been said.
Expuesta y predicada.
Exposed and preached.
Conforme tú has dirigido.
How you have guided me to.
Dan nuestros corazones.
Bless our hearts.
Tú eres quien la hace prosperar.
You're the one that makes providence.
Tú dijiste.
You said.
Que ella no torna atrás vacía.
That she will not fall somewhere empty.
Ella salió con un propósito.
The word left with a purpose.
Y tú has cumplido ese propósito.
And you have served that purpose.
Ahora te rogamos que nos ayudes.
We just ask you to help us.
Asimilar tu providencia.
To assimilate your providence.
A rendirnos.
To submit,
y a someternos,
to give up ourselves,
a tu decreto,
to your decree,
en el nombre de Jesús,
in the name of Jesus,
que esta palabra tuya,
that this word, your word.
nos siga hablando,
can keep speaking to us,
y tú la recuerdas nuestra vida, Espíritu de
and
Dios,
you remind us in our lives,
en los momentos de decisiones,
in the moments of decisions,
y en los momentos de necesidad,
in the moments of necessity,
en el nombre de Jesús,
in the name of Jesus,
te damos la gloria,
we give you glory,
te damos la gloria,
we give you glory,
bendice nuestras vidas,
bless our lives,
ilumina mentes,
illuminate our minds,
levanta cargas,
lift those heavy things from our lives.
Rompe cadenas.
Break those chains.
Rompe las cadenas de las almas.
Break those chains of those souls.
En el nombre de Jesús.
In the name of Jesus.
Cadenas ocultas.
Those hidden chains.
En el nombre de Cristo.
In the name of Christ.
Amén.
Amen.
Amén.
Amen.
Con todo dan gloria al Señor.
I'm going to give glory to God.